that, ladies and gentlemen, is not what you want to see under your car. Alright, so this little fitting, as you can see, this side right here is 1/8 inch NPT. The other side is -4 AN. So, my biggest issue with the fitting that's on the glow shift, or that comes with the glow shift sandwich adapter plate, is that it's a 1/8 inch NPT on both sides. So, what does that mean? An 1/8 inch NPT thread compared to a -4 AN thread, as you can see there's a fine thread for the 1/8 inch and a coarse thread for the -4. So what I got, this is a -4 90 degree AN. This is also a -4 straight AN, and this is what's going to replace the fitting that is on that glow shift sandwich plate. So when I initially did the oil feed setup, it was almost a four and a half foot long braided line, oil feed line, and it's just too long. So I opted for the 36 inch, it's about 3 foot. So I opted for that in lieu of it looking better, it cleaning up. The one thing I did forget though that I wanted to run was some heat shielding. So, and then the other thing that I wanted to talk about was that in my previous video, I don't know if you noticed, my battery voltage was 9, 10 volts jumping around. And this is in no way, shape or form me bashing any of the companies that I'm using. But with the Wiring Specialties harness, I might have to go through and check the wiring on the alternator plug, because when I took it off and I put in the plug that's from the original harness in the vehicle, my voltage shot back up to about 12.7, 13 volts while running. So that tells me that there's either a break or maybe a wire is swapped on the Wiring Specialties harness. And like I said, it's no way, shape, or form I'm not bashing Wiring Specialties. They've knocked it out of the park with this harness. But I figured that out, so now my battery will actually charge instead of the car running just solely on the battery. I don't wanna talk your guys' head off, so I'm gonna go ahead, maybe do a from afar time lapse on the install of that new oil feed, and then I also need to go through and check my power steering lines. I'm still having a small leak coming from there, and I tightened the oil pan bolts, and I'm still getting that little dribble, that little drip coming off the front of the motor there. I don't know if it's the timing cover now or if it's behind that crank pulley. I never did get a chance to solve that issue. But we're gonna go ahead and throw it into this time lapse. We're gonna have a little fun with it today, you guys. All right, it's kind of a long shot from right here, but right here, kind of hard to see it, but right there is where that line's at. So maybe I can get you guys a good little time lapse here. We'll see. The old, in with the new, and you can see right there there's actually a little spot where it got burned through and it was leaking. So at least now I'll know the turbo is going to get sufficient oil, It's not gonna mess any of that up. Alright, so now with the old feed line out, we got our other fitting in our hand here. So what you want to do, find the route with the least resistance. So pretty much where I found the best area is to wrap around. Is to wrap around the intake manifold here. Where we're going to go with it is right in between the runners and the starter, which as long as you got your starter covered with the rubber grommet, you shouldn't have any sparking issues. There we go. Now we got it routed. So now you can kind of see it there. Before I forget as well, you guys, one very crucial part that you need to do on these fittings is put Teflon tape, plumber's tape, something on the threads so you can prevent any future leaks. I had to do the same thing on the turbo, the Pulsar turbo, the GTX 3582R. I had to put Teflon tape on my oil feed fitting because it was leaking. So, with that being said, do not forget that, you guys. Very important step. You have to put this tape. If it's a high pressure line, don't do it. Power steering lines, don't do that. Don't put any thread tape on it. You want to snug those down. Don't over tighten them and don't go too loose, obviously. You never want to do it on a high pressure line, only on oil and air lines. Like if it's an oil feed like this, it's not going to produce any more pressure than what the engine can bring naturally. So. Just like that. A little bit of Teflon tape to eliminate any leaks, you guys. And make sure you put it on where it'll actually go the same way as the fitting or the same way it needs to go into the oil sandwich adapter. So that side's going this way, this side's going this way. So that was kind of strange. So in that video right there, I had a helper turn the wheel left to right, and it's not leaking. I do have a small leak coming off the return on the turbo, but I have a new piece coming for that, so don't worry about that. But the other day when I pulled the car out, there was power steering on the ground. Now it's not leaking. I don't know if it's because it doesn't have any load on the actual rack or what. Sounds good. Alright, so I'm absolutely confident that this thing is camera shy. Because now that I've went through, I let this thing run for the last 20 minutes. And the only thing that I see that's leaking right now is the oil return off the turbo, which, like I said, that will be fixed. I'll be getting the new, it's actually made from Pulsar. It'll be exact fit to a small frame turbo like this one. So. But everything else, like, I am convinced, I'm confident in myself that this thing is camera shy. I take this camera inside and I start it back up, it's probably gonna leak from everywhere. Like, I don't understand it. I think it's time for some B-roll. That's gonna be the end of it. So have a great night, and I'll see you guys on the next one.